गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 12 बायोलॉजी क्लास यूनिट 5 चैप्टर 13 पॉपुलेशन ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड पॉपुलेशंस। टुडेज टॉपिक इज पॉपुलेशन इंटरेक्शंस। मोस्ट ऑफ इकोलॉजिस्ट हैव चूजन द टर्म सिंबियोसिस टू इंक्लूड एंड डिनोट द इंटरेक्शन अमंग प्लांट्स। लिटरली सिंबियोसिस मीन्स लिविंग टूगेदर। इन दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट इट वॉज डीबेरी 1879 हु यूज द टर्म सिंबियोसिस फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम। वेरियस फेनोमेना रिलेटेड विद सिंबियोसिस आर सिंबियोटिक इंटरेक्शंस हैज बीन डिस्क्राइब्ड बाय साइंटिस्ट इन वेरियस वेज। मैकडॉगल्स 1918 हैज डिवाइडेड बायोटिक फैक्टर इंटू टू मेन कैटेगरीज, डिसजंक्टिव सिंबियोसिस डिसजंक्टिव सिंबियोसिस एंड कॉन्जक्टिव सिंबियोसिस। डिसजंक्टिव मीन्स नॉट इन ए परमानेंट कॉन्टेक्ट एंड हियर द ऑर्गेनिज्म लिव इन परमानेंट कॉन्टेक्ट विथ ईच अदर। डिसजंक्टिव सिंबियोसिस में भी सोशल और न्यूट्रेटिव। कॉन्जेक्टिव इज आल्सो सोशल एंड न्यूट्रेटिव। फर्दर न्यूट्रेटिव सिंबियोसिस इज क्लासिफाइड एज एंटागोनिस्टिक्स एंड रेसिप्रोकल्स। दिस इज आल्सो न्यूट्रेटिव। कॉन्जेक्टिव सिंबियोसिस क्लासिफाइड एज एंटागोनिस्टिक एंड रेसिप्रोकल्स। एंटागोनिस्टिक मीन्स अपोजिट टू ईच अदर्स, reciprocals parallel to each others. Adam 1971 considered symbiosis in broader perspective and distinct interaction into two broad categories, positive interactions and negative इंटरेक्शन। पॉजिटिव इंटरेक्शन में भी कॉमेंसलिज, प्रोटो कोऑपरेशन, म्यूचुअलिज्म, नेगेटिव कॉम्पिटिशन, एक्सप्लॉइटेशन, प्रेडेशन, एंटीबायोसिस। कॉम्पिटिशन अदर क्लासिफाइड एज इंटर स्पेसिफिक एंड इंट्रा स्पेसिफिक कॉम्पिटिशन। एक्सप्लॉइटेशन मे बी नेस्ट पैरासिटिक एंड पैरासिटिक। नाउ द पॉजिटिव इंटरेक्शन इन दिस टाइप, दोज टाइप ऑफ इंटरेक्शन आर कंसिडर्ड इन विच बोथ इंटरेक्टिंग स्पेसीज आर म्यूचुअली इन्वॉल्व टू हेल्प ईच अदर। हियर वन इंटरेक्टिंग स्पीसीज हेल्प द अदर आइदर वन वे और ऑन रेसिप्रोकल टर्म एंड मे बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन और शेल्टर और सबस्ट्रेटम और ट्रांसपोर्ट। हियर इंटरेक्शन मे बी ऑब्लिगेटरी और फैकल्टेटिव। पॉजिटिव इंटरेक्शन इंक्लूड्स थ्री टाइप ऑफ इंटरेक्शन, कॉमेंसलिज, प्रोटो कोऑपरेशन एंड म्यूचुअलिज। नाउ कॉमेंसली लिटरली इट मीन्स शेयरिंग कॉमन टेबल। दिस टाइप ऑफ इंटरेक्शन ऑकर्स इन बिटवीन टू ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑफ टू डिफरेंट स्पीसीज इन विच वन स्पीसीज बेनिफिट एंड अदर इज नाइदर बेनिफिटेड नॉर हार्म। The word commensal means sharing the same table. So many commensal relationships involve sharing food with other organisms. This type of relationship of interactions, lineage, epiphytes, epizones, क्लाइन आ जाता, बूडी क्लाइंबर्स फाउंड इन फॉरेस्ट ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश, क्लाइनर्स टेक द हेल्प ऑफ अदर प्लांट्स फॉर सपोर्ट टू क्लाइंब अप, यूजली दे आर नॉट हार्मफुल टू द ट्री आर प्लांट विच प्रोवाइड सपोर्ट, बट द एक्सेसिव ग्रोथ ऑफ क्लाइनर्स कॉज शेडो एंड डिस्टर्ब्ड मेनी वाइटल प्रोसेसेस लाइक ट्रांसपिरेशन, ट्रांसलोकेशन एक्सेट्रा, बिकॉज द ट्विस्टिंग ऑफ क्लाइनर्स अराउंड द स्टेम एंड ब्रांचेज ऑफ सपोर्टिंग ट्री मे नॉट एबल द सपोर्टिंग ट्री टू डेवलप सेकेंडरी टिश्यू ऑफ नॉर्मल ओरिजिन जस्ट बिलो देम एंड मे लीड टू द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ डीप कॉन्स्ट्रिक्शंस। एपिफाइट्स प्लांट्स ग्रोइंग ऑन अदर प्लांट्स आर कॉल्ड एपिफाइट्स, दीज आर ऑटोट्रॉपिक प्लांट्स सो दैट दे कैन सेंडाइज देयर ओन फूड देमसेल्व्स। They are chlorophyllous and possesses two type of roots, aerial root and clinging roots. Aerial roots are provided with velamen tissue to absorb moisture from the atmosphere. Clinging roots absorb mineral substance entering into the bark of tree and provide stability to the epiphyte plants. Well known example of epiphytes are orchid and some fern. Here the plant receive benefit of being supported and held above ground where the light intensity is comparatively greater, but do not harm tree and do not derive any nutrients from the host tree. In temperate region, algae, lichens, mosses grow as epiphytes, but in tropical regions, various fern and phanerogame plants like member of Orchidaceae, Moraceae, Bromeliaceae, एरेसी, पिपरेसी एक्सेट्रा आकर साइज एंड इपीफाइट्स। कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ इपीफाइटिक प्लांट्स, द इपीफाइट्स आर प्रोवाइडेड विथ स्पेसिफिक टाइप ऑफ एरियल रूट विच पॉसेसेस द कैपेसिटी टू एब्जॉर्ब एटमॉस्फेरिक मॉइस्चर बाय देयर पेरिफेरल मल्टीलेयर्ड टिश्यू कॉल्ड वेलामेन टिश्यू। दे आर अटैच ऑन द शेल्टर प्लांट by their clinging roots or rhizoids. Seeds or spores of the epiphytes are very small, very light in weight or hairy. Fruit of some epiphytes are fleshy, for example fruits of family Moraceae. Some epiphytes are saprophytic in nature because they lack chlorophyll and draw nutrient from the dead and decaying tissue, for example Neotia, Epigonon, etc. After epiphytes, there are epizones. Some plants also live on animals in the similar way of epiphytes. They are called epizones. Plants living on the or above the body of animals are called epizones. Excellent example of this category is the green algae that grow on the long root hairs of sloth. Since this algae often become quite abundant to give the animal a greenish appearance, sloth presumably derive some advantages in concealment at each sleep on the tree tops. So due to being greens, it look like the plants and escape from the predators. Some other example of epizones are in human beings. Enormous Escherichia coli bacterial cells are found on the wall of intestine. Presence of green algae on the body surface of polyps. Opelina and Nyctotheres are found in the rectum of frog, which derive nutrition from fecal matter. Sucker fish and shark, interrelation between sucker fish and shark. Sucker fish Remora or Echinus attach itself to the underside of shark by hold fast are sucker formed from its dorsal fin. Sucker fish dispersed by shark to distinct places having better food supply because of its association with shark. Sucker fish is protected from its predators. It obtains food from fragment falling from shark's mouth. Shark does not get any benefit from this association, but also not harmed. Second type of positive interactions is proto-cooperations. Proto-cooperation, the type of interactions where both populations are benefited but not obligatory, that is not essential for the survival of either population, is called proto-cooperations. In the both the species which are living together are benefited from each other, but they can survive independently also. This is also known as non-obligatory or facultative mutualism. The relationship between hermit crab and sea anemone is an example of proto cooperation. The crab use the gastropod or mollusk shell as a portable shield, and the sea anemone eats the leftover food of crab, which is protected from its predators by the stinging shell of sea anemone. Likewise, birds used to sit on the back of cattle like cow and buffalo, crow and buffalo. These eat the lices and ticks and other parasites and protect the cattle. In turn, bird get nutrition. Similar type of proto cooperation is found between rhino and tick bird, Buphegus africans, and also between crocodile and crocodile bird. In crocodiles, leeches are found in jaw. The bird eat leeches when the crocodile open the jaw. Third type of positive interactions is mutualism or symbiosis. Third type of positive interaction is mutualism or symbiosis. When two different species grow together and are mutually benefited, the plants are known as symbiotic plants, and the phenomena is called symbiosis or mutualism. It is a sort of obligatory association. In this type, the organisms are dependent upon each other for survival. In this type of association, two types of species are physiologically related. This type of relationship may exist in between two plants, or in between one plant and one animal, or in between two animals. Some important examples are lichens. This is an association of algae and fungi. Lichens are the group of plants which are formed by the permanent association of algae and fungi. Fungus absorb water for algae, and the algae photosynthesize the food materials for the fungus. Thus, both are mutually benefited. The lives of both become impossible without the help of any one of them, because the algae is photosynthetic but it has feebly developed root systems, therefore cannot absorb mineral and water sufficiently from the soil. For mineral and water, it is dependent on fungus, and fungus is not photosynthetic. For organic food, it is dependent on algae. Lichens grow on the bark of tree or on the stones. Lichens are regarded as classical example of mutualism because the fungus of a lichen can never grow in nature without the associated algae, and the algae are probably dependent upon the fungus under natural conditions. Symbiotic nitrogen fixers. Pulse yielding plants are leguminous plants like pea, gram, bean, lentil, black gram, green gram, Bengal bean and other member of subfamily Papilionaceae possess different size glands in their root called root nodules or bacterial nodules, and root is said to be nodulated roots. They contain the species of Rhizobium, a bacteria which fix atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogenous compounds or nitrates under the process of nitrogen fixation. The bacteria provide nitrogenous compound to the plant. In turn, bacteria get shelter and food from the host plants. In this way, both are benefited from each other. Mycorrhiza and association of fungus with higher plants are gymnospermic plants. Mycorrhizal association also good example of symbiotic association. It is a symbiotic relationship of fungus with the roots of any plants. It is usually observed in the roots of forest plants, for example pinus root. In this type of association, fungus form the mantle on the roots. They form a mat-like structures around the root of higher plants and behave like root hairs, performing the function of absorption of water and mineral salts from the soil. Pinus plant provide living space and food material to the fungus in exchange. On the basis of stabilizement relationship with the root of vascular plants, mycorrhiza may be grouped into three types: ectotrophic mycorrhiza, ectotrophic, endotrophic and ectoendotrophic. Ectoendotrophic or ectoendotrophic. Ectotrophic mycorrhiza form a mycelial sheath around the surface of root, and mycelia occurs intercellularly in the cortical cells of root, for example mycorrhiza of root of pinus, oak, hickories, etc. Endotrophic mycorrhiza in case of mycelium of mycorrhizal fungus enters into the cortex of root and reside intercellularly, for example mycorrhiza of Iridaceae and orchids. Ectoendotrophic, it is an intermediate type. Here infection of mycorrhizic fungus is of ectotrophic type, but mycelia occurs intracellularly. A character akin to endotrophic mycorrhiza, besides providing water and mineral to the plant, mycorrhizic fungus also protect the plant against the attack of soil borne fungi. Another type of symbiosis or mutualism relations is Hydra chlorella symbiosis. Hydra is an animal and chlorella is an algae. Is a good example of mutual interactions, association in between chlorella and hydra. Chlorella grow on hydra and provide manufactured food substance to hydra, and in exchange hydra provides shelter to the chlorella. These are the positive interactions. Now the negative interactions. Those interactions of two different species in which both are harmed or one organism is benefited while other is more or less harmed is referred to as negative interactions. In this type of interaction, one population eats the other type of populations, or one organism does not allow other organism to grow near it by using the food supply of the other or producing toxic substances. Negative interactions we categorize into four categories: competition, then interaction occurs between two species for the use of same resources, and then resources are in short supply is referred to as competition. It is a relationship which involve struggle amongst the organism for food, shelter, water, sunlight and climate. Competition takes place not only amongst the individual of a species but also between the member of two or more species. Hence it can be categorized as intra-specific competitions and inter-specific competition. Intra-specific competition, this is the competition in between individual of same species in a same area. It is also called scramble competitions or intranasine. Here competition occurs for a limited supply of food, light and space amongst the member of same species. In this type of competition, the vigorously growing tree affect weak plants by reducing the available light, nutrients and other factors essential for plant growth. Therefore, the weak plants are gradually eliminated from the area due to lack of enough resources. Inter-specific competition occurs between the member of two different species when the individual of different species use the same resources and then those resources are in limited supply. In this type of competition, two different species may compete for the same space, food or light, or in avoiding predators or diseases, and it may result in one species dying off or being forced to change its ecological niche to utilize a different source of food. This type of interactions occurs with two species of duckweed, Lemna gibba and Lemna polyrhiza. Lemna gibba grows more slowly in pure culture than Lemna polyrhiza. Lemna gibba, however, always found to replace Lemna polyrhiza when they are grown together. Plant body of Lemna gibba has air-filled cavities that serve as little fountains, so that these plants form a mass over the other species, and due to this, Lemna polyrhiza dies. During ideal interspecific competitions, one species only appears as a winner. In agriculture crops, interspecific competition always occurs between weed plants and cultivated crops. Enclosed plant community of grassland, competition among plant species for light and space is very much harmful. Growth of any plants is inhibited due to this competition. Size of inflorescence and number of seed is also decreased. In agriculture, it is a regular practice to remove undesirable plants or weeds from fields because the weeds affect the growth and yield of crops adversely. Second negative interaction is exploitation. The type of interaction in which two species remain together and one species use the other for its shelter, support and nutrition, but harm the latter in direct or indirect way. Exploitation may be of many types, like the nest exploitation, it is found between cuckoos and crows, cuckoo and quail. Cuckoo do not form their own nest. These lay egg in the nest of crows. The crow incubate the eggs and provide food to young ones. Parasitism. Parasite is an organism which is dependent upon other living organisms for their food and other requirements. Parasitism is an interspecific relation, interrelations in which the individual of one species live at the cost of the individual of another species, which is known as host. And they harm to their host and eventually kills. In this case, host is always larger than the parasites. Parasite that is seen on the surface of host plant is called ectoparasites or external parasites. And if a parasite is found inside the plant body, is said to be an endoparasite or internal parasite. Some examples are parasitic bacteria, parasitic bacteria causes several diseases in plants and animals. For example, the citrus canker disease of lemon is caused by Xanthomonas citri. Black root of vegetables of cruciferi group is caused by Xanthomonas campestris. Common disease caused by bacteria in human beings are diarrhea, pneumonia, tetanus, leprosy, plague, etc. Parasitic fungi. Pathogenic or parasitic fungi also cause many diseases in plants, like rust caused by Puccinia, smut by Astilogo, bunts by Tilletia, blights by Phytophthora, dumping up of seedlings, Pythium, anthracnose, Coleotricum, leaf spots, Helminthosporium, etc. And in animals, in man, parasitic fungi cause skin, neck and throat diseases. Angiospermic parasitic plants. Some angiospermic plants also behave as parasites. They may be partial or total parasites. Total parasites may be root parasites, total root parasites or total stem parasites. Partial parasites are also partial root parasites and partial stem parasites. Total parasites. Angiospermic parasitic plants, they may be total parasites or obligate parasites. Total parasites, those parasitic plants which completely dependent on other host plants for their food are called total parasites. They are total root parasite, means they obtain shelter and food from the root of host plant. Total root parasite grow on the root of host. Example is Aurobenchi, Balanophora, Rafflesia, Stringa, etc. Aurobenchi grows on the root of potato, tomato, brinjal, tobacco, etc. It obtains water and food from the host through their haustoria. Stinga is an example of total root parasites of sugar cane. And ultimately, they destroy the host plant. Total stem parasite. These parasites obtain their food from the stem of host by producing haustoria into them. Examples are Cuscuta, Cuscithach. Cuscuta is a very common and important total stem parasite. It is a leafless flowering stem. It is a leafless flowering stem parasite. The seed germinate in the soil and develop into twiner. After some time, it becomes attached with neighboring plant and dissociate with the soil, and then haustoria roots originate from the stem of Cuscuta and penetrate the host to procure nutrients from the vascular region of host plants and ultimately destroy the host plants. Cuscuta is found everywhere. You have seen yellow thread-like structures spread over any plant. Partial parasites. The plant which are capable of manufacturing their own food but depend upon host plant for water and mineral salt supply. Partial parasites are also categorized into partial root parasite and partial stem parasite. The partial root parasites, Sandalum album, popularly known as Chandan or Sandalwood, is a partial root parasite. It grows on root of host such as Albizia, Dalbergia, Eucalyptus, etc. And they prepare their food by using nutrient drawn from the host. Also, this is a tree nature plant, but its root system is not well developed, so that they absorb mineral and water from the root of other plants. Partial stem parasite. Some chlorophyllous parasitic plants get nutrient from the xylem of stem of host and synthesize their own food with the help of the sunlight. Such parasites are called partial stem parasites. For example, Larynthus, Viscum, etc. A parasite possesses much of its life on or in the body of its living host, from which it derives nutrients. Most successful parasite is that which does minimum harm or does not harm its host. Third type of negative interaction is predation. In which one organism feeds upon other organism to obtain food by hunting is predation. A predator is an animal or plant that kills and feeds on another organism, that is its prey. It represents a generalized carnivorous habit. Commonly, predators are larger than their prey, but this is not always true. But predator is, in any case, always occurs as a naturally better equipped a hunter than its prey. Most of predatory organisms are animals, but there are some plants, carnivorous, also especially fungi, which feed upon other animals. Many fungi like Dactylaria, Dactylella, Arthrobotrys, Juzuphagus capture insects, nematodes, and other such animals. These fungi possess a specialized adaptive feature of mycelial origin to trap the nematodes. Important examples of predators are grazing or browsing. Grazing or browsing, literally grazing means eating of grasses एंड हर्बेसियस प्लांट्स बाय डोमेस्टिक एज वेल एज वाइल्ड एनिमल वेयर एज ब्राउसिंग इज द ईटिंग ऑफ फोलियज ऑफ लार्ज श्रब्स एंड ट्रीज बाय एनिमल्स. डिफरेंट प्लांट्स रिसीव वेराइंग डिग्री ऑफ हार्म एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ ब्राउसिंग एंड ग्रेजिंग. सम एनिमल्स प्रेफर टू यूज फोलियज ऑफ सम सेलेक्टिव प्लांट्स एंड हेंस दे रिड्यूस द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ द प्लांट इन द ग्रेज्ड एरिया. Grazing and browsing reduce the density of grasses and shrub in forest so that fire hazards are reduced. In forest, some seeds are buried slightly in the soil during grazing, so the frequency of germination of seed is high. Grazing and browsing have some harmful effect also. For example, the seedling of desired species have been eaten by grazing animals owing to the activity of moving cattle. The soil become compact and it create poor soil aeration. As a result, water absorbing capacity of soil become low and the land become susceptible to erosion. Heavy grazing and browsing change the vegetation in an area. Even a thick forest may be converted into grassland or even desert as Thar and Sahara. Destruction of seed and seedlings. Many insects, birds, squirrel, mice, other rodents are dependent upon seeds as they are satisfactory source of food and cause heavy loss of seeds and thereby reduce quantity of seed production by the plants. Not only this, the seedlings of desired plants have been destroyed by the feet of these animals. Insectivorous plants, those plants which obtain nitrogen compound from the body of insects by killing them are called insectivorous plants. These plant possesses insect catching organs or part through which they catch or trap the insect, kill it and then absorb and assimilate the nitrogen compound of their body. A number of plants are Nepenthes, Drosera, Dionaea, Utricularia, etc. consume insect and other small animal for their food. They are also known as carnivorous plants. The leaf pitcher of Nepenthes is large, provided with a immobile lids. This is filled with nectar-like substance and digestive juice are separated from the ball of inner ball of pitcher, which has protein digesting enzymes. Nepenthes is large, provided with an immovable lid. The pitcher is wide at the base and tapering towards the apex. Inner surface of upper portion of pitcher is lined with nectariferous glands which secrete nectaries or sugary syrup. Similar glands are also present at the ribbed rim of the mouth. Below the neck of the internal surface of pitcher has two regions. Upper is without glands but has waxy coating due to which it becomes slippery. Some cells produce hair-like curved outgrowth which point downwards and are located above the slippery surface. In the lower region, there are present a number of multicellular button-shaped digestive glands which secrete digestive enzymes. The pitchers attract insects due to red color of the lid and nectar secreted by the nectariferous glands. Insects move inwards and outward in search of more nectar and fall down in the cavity of the pitcher through the slippery surface. It gets entangled in the fluid, proteolytic enzyme secreted by digestive glands. The proteinaceous matter are broken down into peptide and amino acids which are absorbed by the cells of ball of pitcher. Another example is Utricularia. It is a rootless, insectivorous, aquatic plant. Some segment of leaves form bladder, also known as bladder bud, which possesses trapdoor with bulb for insect on the mouth and many digestive gland on the bulb. Many aquatic insects enter into the bladder through trapdoor along with water stream. When an insect enters the bladder, bulb of trapdoor become closed and digestive gland produce digestive juice for the digestion of insects. Finally, the digestion material along with nitrogenous compounds are absorbed by the plant. In Drosera or sundew plant, leaves are flat and round and produce many pinhead-like glandular hairs called tentacles. Tentacles are sensitive and produce a sticky liquid which help in catching the insects. Digestive gland produce the digestive enzyme in the form of juice for the digestion of insects. After predation, four type of negative interaction is antibiotics or antibiosis. Antibiosis is the complete or partial inhibition or death of one organism by the another through the secretion or production of some substance or environmental condition as a result of their metabolism. Antibiosis is a cause of amensalism, which involve a type of chemical interaction by which the individual of one species affect the well-being and growth of individual of other species. For example, Microcystis, an algae of blue-green algae group, produce a toxic substance like hydroxylamine that causes the death of fish and even the cattle that drink the water. About 50% of species belonging to actinomycetes and 50% of lichens, as well as large number of fire plants, produce substance that inhibit mold and bacteria. Chlorella, a common member of green algae, also produce a bacterial site that not only kills bacteria but also retards the growth of Daphnia, which feed on chlorella.